It feels nice and cool in here. The weather's like starting to get shitty outside.
She went to go buy some shit to drink. I was gonna order it on Amazon Prime now, but she was like, "Oh, it's cheaper now." Yeah. I'm like, "All right, if you want to carry 4 cases of water in, okay. I mean, it is cheaper. I won't stop you."
Sometimes it's probably just good to get out of it for 10, 20 minutes, you know?
Yeah, I don't know. It's crazy, apparently. It's in the rain.
Stuff from the shop?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like, we're like half pretty much now. You know?
Yeah.
I'm like, alright.
You got nothing to say for water, too?
Yeah. All I got is a Perrier.
What's that coat you want?
Yeah.
You know me, I'm a pound of water all day.
For some reason, I knew you were gonna like it. Water in a cake.
No way. I love it. That's dope.
I mean,
straight water or what?
Sparkling, but yeah.
Oh, okay. I love it.
It's like just their marketing, and it's like, I thought you'd like it. I was like, just don't mind. Tell me, wait, I got a better one for you. Yeah, murder your thirst. Bitch, murder.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's like, dope. So I was like, I knew you'd like to.
Hey!
Oh, pour it to water.
Yeah, I know.
That's
what I was like, what
can you think about?
I was like,
you should like it.
Very interesting. I didn't know you could actually really make water look cool, right?
Yeah. So I was like, I don't know why, but I feel like you're gonna dig this too.
Listen to shit. Once your thirst has been murdered, the soul of your thirst will begin to escape and flow towards the ceiling. At this point, drink a second sip.
I'm like,
I don't know what happened, something just dropped back here.
Yeah, it's not the ball, no. It's not crazy.
Something just dropped.
Yeah, I dropped it. I knew it was okay.
All right.
I just didn't look to see if I had anything to do. It's like something scary, yeah. Huh? It's like something scary. Yeah.
It freaked me out. You know,
I saw you jump.
I look PTSD, like, you know?
It's like, you know, something scary. I'm like, I didn't register, I just didn't realize. Like, I thought that I had a couple things like on it or in front of it. I was about to argue before you know which way you are in the car. You can see the story outside of this report. You bring your tons and your chips into the bank account and you talk about a car. This is a place where you are always at home.
This is your pistol morally. Bricks. was a drummer named his two daughters.
We're on this?
No, it's a joke. What did the drummer name his two daughters?
Two daughters?
And a one, and a two.
Oh, okay, all right.
Okay. Alright,
it's like,
oh, okay, we're still
camera guys. I still don't get it, so I had to give him like a sympathy laugh. I don't even get it.
Yeah. He's just telling bad jokes.
Oh, is that
Mike's just like a dad now. I don't know what happened.
Oh, he just
went. Yeah, he's sort of like to a dad. Started dating this young girl, and now he just tells dad jokes around
here. Shit, yeah.
Now he has a cat.
Really?
Yeah. Not only do they have a cat, Ryan, together, Mike has a backpack for the cat so they can bring it around. You know, one of those like bubbles?
Yeah.
They have that.
Really?
And they take the cat to the bar with them.
No way. To the bar?
I'm not even making this up. You'll have to ask Mike about it. Next time he comes in here with a bad joke. Okay, here you got a cat now. And you bring it around in a backpack.
That's hilarious.
You call him Cat Daddy.
Cat Daddy.
it's getting interesting,
right? Yeah. That was,
this one you think that one ain't gonna stay around, you know?
Yeah.
You know, they get a pet together, you know?
Yeah, I don't give shit more than like a month.
Yeah. Typically, yeah.
How long
has
that been? Like,
this has been a couple months now, at least.
Wow.
I know.
You get a cat,
yeah, I think she already lives there. That's good. Good for now. I was like, we're on a thing. Mike's got a cat. I knew you'd like that story.
Yeah, that's funny shit.
Like a cat daddy. It's better than girls I can teach you. The thing that makes me guys go crazy for.
There's a business coming to it. Start a business, like, you're always talking to frustration and like rising to the challenge, like not wanting to be defeated, you know?
Well, I feel that. Like, I found out, I think it was yesterday, I got a loan.
Oh, yeah.
By a physician, so that was kind of cool.
Oh, yeah.
Now I can pay off that other loan I have.
That's awesome.
And at least have more time to pay it off after the payroll thing. So it's going to be better.
Yeah.
So we need some money to do the powerhouse gym thing.
Oh, there you go. That was.
You know? Which is. Come on now, you know?
Yeah.
And I'm like, all right, we in it.
Well, that's what do they say? Be careful what you wish for, right?
That's why I was like,
you've been talking about that for a long time.
That's why I said, I was like, see, I was fucking around. This is what I get.
Exactly, right.
And so I was like, I talked to him too. What was the last day we worked out with you? Friday? Mm-hmm. I saw him on Friday.
No, what are you talking about? We just trained on Wednesday.
Wednesday, yeah. Well, yeah,
yesterday.
Yeah, I saw him, and we were talking about it. So I'm like, all right, it's still happening. No backing out now.
Yeah, right.
He's like, no, we want you in there, you know? All right. So I was like, then I got the no news. I don't know what the loan's going to prove us. That's the only thing I don't know. And I'm like, what are you doing?
Yeah, it's not meant to be, right?
I'm like, cool. Pretty good amount. So I'm like, I'm not glad I talked to my accountant.
Yeah, right.
Because he was like, don't take more than this much. Because then you have to put a collateral.
Oh, shit, okay.
So it's in the business's name, it's not mine, and I'm not going to put a collateral.
That's really good.
Right?
Yeah.
Or I'm like, shit, okay.
Thank you.
Check out this new site. I might be able to offer like, you know, equipment and shit on my website along with supplements. No.
What kind of equipment? Like workout equipment? Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Like, you know, claws, weight belts, kettlebells, dumbbells, mats, that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Right?
Why not?
Well, if you're on the site looking for supplements, you know, and stuff, could be helpful. Or, you know, like, let's say, for instance, like, if I have, like, a preference, if I want you, like, if all my clients using, like, sheep straps and certain kind of Cordella weight belt, you know, like that's what I'm looking for. I don't know if they
I know Amazon.
They don't.
They're
yeah,
like
an affiliate.
Like,
yeah. Yeah, exactly.
That's what I was like. I know you can do that on your page. Mm-hmm. You can sell stuff for your page on Amazon,
mm-hmm.
and then you get like a commission.
Yeah, it's us. I was definitely looking into that.
Scared me, nothing happened.
I'm sure. probably have some of your regulars coming back and, you know, some new business and, like, you know.
Yeah.
Monday night, Tuesday and Thursday night.
You're like, how late, bitch? What's night be?
Well, Monday's a pack, so Tuesday, Thursday, I'm not. No, not at all. Down the road, coffee, Tuesday, Thursday, Thursday morning, early afternoon, but that's I'm actually using all that extra time right now to get a good book for a fucking house. No. I don't feel comfortable at all if I have to be in your house. It's fucking Airbnb is stressful.
I know, it's that one client of yours that I cut.
Yes. Yeah, Dean. Remind you to. This gets mad confused on both sides, like,
okay.
No? Yeah, no, see, I've been training her for, like, on up, like, 10 years. She's awesome. Yeah, she's really good. Yeah. Yeah, but, you know, her daughter's moving back in there where I'm at the end of the month. So, I have less than 30 days. Yeah, I'm fucking in time crunch. I don't know where to go after that. I mean, of course, I have to really start looking hardcore around the look.
Well, the good news is you can rent another Airbnb.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
That's ideal.
Yeah.
But, you know, I learned that recently. You can rent an Airbnb for like a month.
Cheap?
Yeah. Like, besides just your friend, like, I think somebody was renting one around here. Because he wanted to see how he liked Tampa before he moved.
Yeah, right, of course.
And he was in like some of these nice ones over here in New York.
Was it over
100,000? It was over, but it wasn't a whole lot, and it included everything.
Okay.
You know, and he didn't know this person.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I know it's cheaper where you're at now because you know her.
Yeah.
But, you know, like, he was paying like, I think, like $1,200 a month.
Okay.
And it, but it's like a nice townhome. But he was renting like a townhome.
Okay.
A one-bedroom townhome in Ybor. And he had like a
$1,200. Oh, really? Oh, wow.
That's why I was like, it wasn't bad. It was like $1,250, something like that. It was cheap for that. For what it was cheap. That's why I was like, you might find a little baller-ass spot to rent for a month or two if you had to, in this case.
Yeah.
You know? Because I'd probably do that now before I get into anything, because the rental markets for Airbnbs, if you pick an area that sucks, it's not that close to the beach, are great.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like one in, what was it, like Seminole Heights or somewhere where it's just not going to be as popping. You can live in a cute little spot for a while. You know?
Yeah.
Not the end of the world. I checked that too.
Okay.
But you know, you're going to be in a house forever, so you want to pick that.
You're right. I know.
You can figure it out for a few months for renting cheap Airbnbs. You're not going to get a better time than right now because nobody can really travel and do anything.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Whereas, like, this shit will be expensive in Tampa otherwise.
You're right.
I could rent a fucking beachfront spot right now for hardly anything. Even though the beach is kind of packed because they're getting a lot of cancellations and stuff, I'm sure. Because of the shit. You know, where normally right now it'd be like $400 a night for the room I want in the place I want, but I can get them for like
$180.
Oh, shit, that's crazy. So I was like, when this loan goes through.
Yeah, right.
I'm making good money right now. I'm just, bro, I pay $1,000 a week in the loan.
Holy shit.
And I have to pay the rent for the barbershop.
Right, yeah. Oh, yes, right. You took the hard money off, didn't you?
That's what I said. It's worth a shitload.
Yes.
I mean, when I took it, I was making like $2,000, $2,500 a week, bro. You know, I was making like $2,000 a week, easy. I was doing $2,500 when I was pushing it. Now it's just not even like that.
It will, though. It'll be better. Yeah, I promise.
Just say it. Just ain't even like that.
Get down, girl, don't get down. Get down, girl, don't get down. Get down. Thank you. I want your love and I want your revenge. You and me, you're right back.
up? Hi, girl.
What's up? I'm living.
Making a little shop run out there.
Just made it in right out of the clouds. We're just breaking
off. Oh,
really?
Yeah,
it's just started
pouring. Oh, damn.
I'm going to park right the front here and unload. Yeah. Can we get you something to drink?
Huh?
Can we get you something to drink?
Oh, man, I just had a water. Thank you, though. Yeah.
I wanna be friends with you now.
I might do a beer if you have one.
Yeah,
you go train a little bit. Sometimes I like to flip it as hard. Marlo used to love beer when he trained. You know that?
I did not know.
Old school, hot. Break or vibrate.
I'll stop soon. His first
test
product was beer and water.
Wow, that's really cool. So beer and water, really?
Beer and water.
Yeah, that's cool. That's cool. Always wonder, like, back in the day, like, you know, it's like, how they find out about this shit, you know?
Yeah, here, it's like now that, like, when you look at me, like, hair products and
our,
like, ingredients and stuff, like...
I always thought back in the day we would crush up berries, you know, and then use, like, oil, like, olive oil, coconut oil, right? Is that good?
Mm-hmm. It's depending, like, coconut oil is a larger stuff molecule, so it's, like, it's too big to really...
It ends up being absorbed,
Yeah.
The same thing when I try to put on my skin, like, the skin doesn't really absorb it.
It's
like if you're trying to
make
water and oil. Yeah, they're going to make.
Right. And then I'll do an oil on top. So, like, an argan oil, marula oil.
That's all good stuff for the face.
Yeah. Is that chewy? No, I don't get shit in my face.
Yeah.
I'm like, stop picking at your face. Like, screams down the hall. It's like, I was just picking at my face.
I do that too. I'm a bad picker. My arms, like, that's why I'm actually, I want to go find somebody that's late hair removal. Like, just on my form, see if that will help, you know?
Yeah.
I'm tired of dealing with that shit. I've had it forever. Stress on the bone is what causes your bones to absorb those nutrients. So that's
sorry,
why.
You're working the bonus.
You're working the bonus, exactly. Yeah.
Interesting.
Yep, exactly.
Oh my god, what did we watch yesterday where the guy, oh, he was like a Bill's fan, and he like jumped from like a van onto a table, and like you can just see it, and whoever is filming it, like, oh, his
life is
broken. So he got fucked up, huh? He goes, this is my broken puppy, no! And then they zoom in.
Oh, shit.
And I'm just like, what? I'm like, what's he doing in this situation right now?
Right? How stupid can you be? Well, you know, when you're, you know, we got probably a lot of people looking at you, and you're trying to be a badass, and you're drunk. You know?
Yeah.
Fuck that.
I've never seen an asshole. I think they're really white.
Huh?
I think they're really white.
What's that?
Bones.
Bones? Yeah.
Like when they're first exposed.
Yeah.
I've never seen a broken bone.
A broken tongue, but I never had a compound fracture which sticks out of your skin, you know?
That's what I'm like, that's a pretty good one.
That's
yeah.
When you're fucked up. When it comes out of your skin, then you're fucked up.
I've never broken anything.
But I'll tell you, that's the most, one of the reasons that fascinates me about just the body and fitness is one of the things is how it can regenerate, right? You know, close bones and our skin replicates, you know, every 30 days our skin is shed, form new, you know. Like, we're just talking about your face, for instance. Like, when you're working out and you're straining, that's building the muscles under your face, and it actually helps keep your face looking youthful, you know. It's small shit like that, you know. Yeah, all the people I know that are in great shape, look great in their 60s, 70s, they take care of themselves. You know what I'm saying?
Just hit me with the truth.
Is she a rapper or some shit?
No.
What does she do?
Nothing.
No.
Famous for this show.
No. Just for this show?
Yeah.
That's hilarious. Kind of cute. Like, you know, she's got a good personality. She's a little dumb.
Yeah, that's how they keep her around.
Huh?
They keep her around.
Yeah, right. I know. Yeah, she's
just says dumb, cute shit.
Right, I know. No, she's cute, but this bitch is dumb.
Yeah.
I could have sworn she was somebody though. No?
No.
I don't know.
Wow.
No, not that I know.
They literally have to make a name for her. She's like Chanel West Coast.
Chanel West Coast? Wow. Alright.
I think how it started was they were looking for another personal assistant for him.
For him?
Yeah.
He was.
Oh my god!
That's just about. How fun would that be though? Like, that's your job. Are you shitting me? That's your job.
The rain!
Well, he did not know that they were on his back?
I think he passed out.
Yeah, he probably thought they were those suction things in
the hospital.
Oh, this. The hospital?
Stop it.
No. Oh my gosh. What the fuck? Oh my gosh.
And like
the hospital.
Jiggling.
The hospital. Are you shitting me? Can you imagine that story? That's hilarious. Oh
Asking me if I wanted it.
Oh, really? What, the sink?
Yeah. So I'm like, no, I gotta buy a shampoo today.
Now, do you have a guy that can help you with all, like, installing all that shit, or I have two of my clients that are contractors.
Oh, yeah, you're one guy. I have a guy
he's
unreliable.
Okay.
Problem is that, like, he's, like, one of those people who works for, like, next to nothing. And so, like, there's some guy who we work for who, like, consistently has worked for him. You know what I mean?
Yes.
And so he's constantly tied up with this guy.
Okay.
And even though this guy technically pays less per job than I do, this guy pays him weekly.
Okay,
so it's like, I don't need projects. So, like, I don't know, I feel like, especially him anymore, ever since he's, like, working for this guy, he's been, like, really unreliable. So we have to do it basically and not do it every job.
Okay, gotcha.
Like, Sunday and Saturday. You know?
Yeah.
And so, like, I don't know. That's why I was like, you know, I've used him, I like him, I trust him, but at the same time, that motherfucker's unreliable.
Yeah. I can't do it on a lot of people, you know?
Do you know what I mean?
I know, exactly.
Like, he's the one who installed, like, the carpet in my house, that's the, my rental.
Yeah.
And, like, I've been trying for months to get him, like, to confirm on a date so he can take it out. Because it broke, or whatever. And I wanted him to come take it out. And I was like, well, you put it in, you know? And
yeah.
I know he put it in some weird fuck-ass way.
Yeah.
I know him.
Gotcha.
You know, where he, like, did it his own way.
Yep.
So I'm like, it would just be easier rather than someone else having to figure out how you built this box around it. And,
right, right.
And it was, like,
right.
Going through this, and it's just, like, you can never do it. So you're going to hire someone else. It's like, he's the one who did the flooring and the shampoo sinks here. You know? So, it's not he does bad work, it's just getting him here and getting him to come into a job.
Gotcha.
It can be hard sometimes. You know?
Yeah.
That's the harder part. It was like with the shampoo thing. That's shit. I think they took it over, like, well, I don't remember how many days it was down. But, like, that was the last project I had him around for that he's reliable to.
Uh-huh.
But even then, like I said, I want to say we had to do certain things, like rip the flooring out partly, and then he didn't finish it all, and then he came back to finish it. I want to say we were only down, like, one day without a shampoo. Some parts of life I like, some parts of life I don't like, you know?
Not
She wasn't over a bottle of bread. A Wednesday job and a Saturday. So I can't.
On the floor. So don't try to run up in my ear talking all that raspy shit. Trying to ask some shit. When my niggas take it, that's not even past some shit. You should think about it. Take a second. Matter of fact, you should take 4 feet and then before you fucking go skateboard beat. Move the pimp to the crib, mom.
Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. He's trying to get you. Walk it like it's hot. Walk it like it's hot. Walk it like it's hot. Walk it like it's hot.
If a nigga get an attitude,
pop it like it's hot.
I'm a gangster, but y'all need it. The big boss dog, yeah, I had to do that. I keep a blue flag hanging on my backside, but only on the left side.
Yeah, that's a great side.
Come on, look away.
Lady came on my
yacht. I cut so much, you thought I was a DJ. Two, three, 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 three
scene, double low beat, even double G. I can't get it, just break it in the way I see that specialize in making all the girls be naked. So bring the clothes for y'all from the side. We got a real career right here, like it was. So don't change the whistle, turn it out a little. I got a ring and room for the fun and out of business. We need a little bit of a whistle, and a shizzle. Jesus, we just have nothing to do with this. Drop it like a song, drop it like a song, drop it like a song. We're just trying to hit it. Park it like a song, park it like a song. Walking like a child, if a nigga get an attitude, popping like a child, popping like a child, popping like a child. I got the Rodeo on, no Porsche on, down in the hole, that's me, cause I got it going on. I'm a bad boy, born by the homies, drive my own cars, and wear my own clothes. I think I'm tough, I'm a real boss, I can't shoot a gun, get me some show. I'm too scared in the magazines, I can pay the cost, I'm on the red beat. We got a girl, so we wanna pop back. AK-47, now nigga, strap back. See me shit, now I ain't moving. Down this corner, now you ain't moving. They can't find you, but now you miss you. Must not remind you, I'm only here to twist you. Pistol with you, dip you, and flip you. Can dance to this motherfucking music and crap too. So come on, nigga, get your issue. Baby, come close, let me see how you get loose. Drop it like a song, drop it like a song. Drop it like it's hot, kids try to get it. Park it like it's hot, park it like it's hot, park it like it's hot. If a nigga get an attitude, pop it like it's hot, pop it like it's hot, pop it like it's hot. I got the booty on the road, you know, boy, Sean Don, and I'm over that sweet, cause I can't go alone.
Thank you. Best thing to do is stay low. Lots of J-Lo's, they ask what they do, but they know.
Across the street from your old shop, right there?
Yeah.
Wow, okay.
So they're like, that's like going to be a new five-star hotel.
I would love that be.
So my thing is that, so either Ybor is going to change,
right.
And there's going to be classier, and yep. Almost to the standards of
right,
that,
right.
Or that place is just going to get trashed.
Right.
Within
right.
A few years.
Yeah.
And I'm just not sure how it's going to pan out. Because right now, we're not a place that needs a five-star hotel.
Right, I agree.
Like, it's going to get rented and people are going to do drugs in there.
Yeah.
So I'm just waiting to see. Because it's like that one, I think it's a Mary House or something, Bar House. Right there, it's like on the corner. And it's like expensive. It's a five-star dining restaurant.
Okay.
And they're always good. Because I was like, I'm pretty sure when they started building this, they thought that hotel was going to be finished on time.
Yeah, right, yeah.
They thought they'd have a homeless to clientele, and I don't see it. Because I guess some CP board is a place where people come for fine dining.
Yeah, I agree.
I think they're thinking of like furniture and they're seeing like what's going on over there.
Yeah.
And they're like, we want in on that. But I'm like, Ybor's dirty as fuck. Okay?
Yeah.
I'm not trying to be funny.
Yeah, anyway, furniture works because it's right down to some of the height. No?
Ybor's dirty. Like, I'm not trying to be a dick, but every bar I go into, all the bathrooms.
No, I agree. I just...
It's like they don't even try.
Yeah, I know.
There's a difference between being, like, a grungy bar and a bar that doesn't clean.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of like a mayor constantly at Ybor and bars that just don't clean.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I think that affects it.
Well, like, when I feel, like, what, that one time, right after, like, the restaurants were just started opening up, we went to the WAB in Brandon, World Beer Brandon.
Oh,
it always smells weird, like, when we walk in.
Uh-huh.
I just thought there was like a pipe that was burst somewhere or something.
You know, and then like this time we're like,
smells
that. It doesn't smell that. It was
just
that they weren't cleaning enough. I'm like,
that's pretty funny. Wow. I'm like, yeah, oh, yeah. I assume
this was something you guys couldn't
have cleaned in one shift.
Yeah, right.
You know what
right,
I mean?
Yeah.
One COVID cleaning.
I do notice that,
yeah,
though.
Right?
You notice
I'm
that
like,
after, I'm going in a lot of establishments that have been closed for 3 months, you can tell that they're like deep clean. A lot of places.
Yeah,
right.
But I'm like, it's disgusting.
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Like, I just assumed it was like a bar drainage pipe was clogged or something like out of their control. I didn't know it was just like literal bar fuzz gunk.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I'm like, that's disgusting.
No, sometimes, you know.
Crazy.
Yeah.
No, crazy, mommy.
Yeah, sometimes I know that if you leave beer around or if you don't clean it for a long time, it kind of ferments and molds it up. You know?